بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome everyone who watches me from any place in the world. We have a lot of الحمد لله audience came from different places. Special thank for those who are in UK. Inshallah, I'm coming to visit UK inshallah in 21st of February بإذن الله تعالى in London and Manchester City and also inshallah Leicester City بإذن الله تعالى. Today inshallah week we gonna sail with the fifth maqam. We started this series, which how to bring the maqams in the easiest way. And we already talked about maqam al-saba, then maqam al-nahawand, then maqam al-ajam. Then we talked also last week about maqam al-bayat. And this week, inshallah, we're going to talk about maqam al-sika, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. To perform maqam al-sika in the best way, you have to know what the meaning of sika first. Sika, it's Persian expressions. It means that the third level of the voice, the third pitch, actually. To bring the third pitch with maqam al-sika, which is its happy maqam, you are expressing happiness, especially when you recite ayat talking about al-jannah or ayat talking about al-muttaqeen, ayat talking about al-abrar. I had talking about taqwa. In that time, when you bring maqam al-sika, it will touch your heart, then your recitation also will touch the hearts of those who are listening to you, inshallah ta'ala. But there is a two tunes of maqam al-sika, and these are the easiest keys or the easiest, let us say, tunes or dimensions of maqam al-sika. If you just memorize them a lot, you can, after that, perform them when you are reciting. But let us just start with the first tune of Maqam al-Sika in this way. First tune or the first part of the tune. We have the last part of the tune, which when you end maqam al-sika, how to end it? In this way. I need from you now to repeat these two tunes, which is the beginning of the maqam and the end of maqam. I want from you to collect them, to listen to them and repeat them more than 50 times. Because we wanted to firm these maqams or these tunes in your receiver, in your mind. To receive them and to memorize them and to find them when you wanted to use them, you have to repeat them and also listen to them a lot. Let me now start with Surah Al-Fatiha. In the beginning of Al-Fatiha, I'm going to bring the first tune. Then the end of the Fatiha, I'm going to bring the last tune. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The tune again. How to recite by Al-Fatiha with the same tune? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. I end Al-Fatiha with وَلَضَّالِّينَ. I end it with the second tune actually and the second part of the maqam al-sika. طيب, how to make تكبيرة الإحرام even when you say Allahu Akbar and we wanted to recite this maqam during the salah, you should start تكبيرة الإحرام also with the same tune. يلا, the tune again. Is that right? This is the tune. Yalla, start. Allahu Akbar. Now you are ready to recite with Surah Al-Fatiha or with every Surah with this unique maqam. See you inshallah next week. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.